Hi, welcome back to my channel. If you tuned in last week, then this is a continuation of what it takes to become a singer. And if you did not, you need to go back to that video, watch that video, and then come back and watch this one. Okay? So decide how it's gonna go. Okay. Hi, welcome back. I would like you very much to press subscribe, comment below, all of those great things that YouTubers do, because I'm not a YouTuber officially yet, but you're gonna help me get there. I decided to start a series on the psychology of singing because I've watched a lot of YouTube videos on how to sing, what it takes to do vocally, how you need to, you know, what part of the voice and what part of the body it takes to sing. Okay, great, la la la, we do a lot of scales and all of these things on YouTube. It's really, really awesome, but it really, really starts with the psychology of singing. What's going on in your mind? How are you approaching singing? And how do you actually approach the idea of becoming a singer? So if you watched my video last week, then you saw that I said to you, the first thing you need to do is decide. Because when you walk into the space of decision, then everything that follows after that is really solid. You have a sort of solid ground of what you're doing in a career. So this week, I kind of want to continue on with that sort of idea of deciding, because wow, what does it take to become an artist? And how much courage does it take to become an artist? And a lot of people don't have that courage, and they make a B plan and they say, my dad told me that I should have a backup plan. Well, I say to you, you don't need to do a backup plan. You need to decide, am I a singer? Am I an artist? And you need to know that being an artist is not the same thing as going and learning to be a doctor. Being an artist is not the same thing as going and learning to be an accountant. There's all these different ways to achieving being an artist, and that scares the hell a lot of people. It sort of makes you feel like, okay, I'm on this isolated little island over here. I don't have a pension plan. I don't have a plan for when I'm 65 years old to retire. We don't retire. You don't ever retire from being an artist. You're an artist. Once you decide you're an artist forever. Okay? That's how it goes. And yeah, it's a little bit scary. And yeah, when you walk on that stage and you're going to be judged and everybody in the world is going to judge you, it's scary. But guess what? It's so rewarding to do what you love. And to be an artist is to sing and make art and whatever. I mean, we're talking about singing here, but whatever art you decide to do, it's very rewarding. Are you able and are you willing to get on a tour bus and sleep on a tour bus to make it to the next city to sing for those people? Are you willing to sleep maybe in a shitty hotel? Who knows? But it's really, really for your dream, right? So I think that's what I really, really want to help you. I want to help you take those steps toward the beingness, being a singer. Because guess what? It takes a lot of courage, and it actually takes a lot of action. You got to make those plans. You got to sit down and write, okay, in 5 years, I see myself here. And in 6 years, I see myself here. And in 10 years, I see myself here. And it's just like anything else. Guess what? Not only do you become a singer when you decide to become a singer, you become an entrepreneur when you decide to become a singer. Because being a singer and being an artist, you have to constantly create. You have to constantly say, okay, this is the direction I'm going to go in. I'm going to sit down with some people around me and put some really great people around me, a great team around me that will flow me ideas and help me grow this business. Because being a singer is a business. And we'll get down to that during this series on the business of singing. Once you've really decided, see, because last week I sort of stepped on the idea of you stepping on stage and the psychology of singing. Okay, so you said, you must have said, I am a singer for you to come back to this video, right? So now that you're a singer and you really say, okay, I'm a singer and I'm deciding to walk the path of an artist, what do I have to do, Stacy? Okay, so I'm going to give you a little sort of an assignment this week. I want you to send me a video of you singing. Okay, now some of you might, your heart might have just dropped and was like, no way, no way in hell am I seeing this lady a video. And I'm telling you, yes way in hell, send me the video. Okay, we're gonna start with just a video for me. I'm not gonna show the world. I ain't gonna take it on my social media and blast it out and say, look at this person singing. It's just for me. I want you to comment below, okay, I am sending you a video so I know to go look for it, okay? My email is thestacyfrancisshow@gmail.com. It's thestacyfrancisshow@gmail.com. And I want you to send me a video, because as we go through these steps together, I wanna not only help you in your decision, but I wanna help you along the way and give you some tools and ideas. Because see, for me, what I found is that I have a lot of really successful friends. I have really superstar friends. They're really amazing. And I have friends that are working on cruise ships, and I have friends that sing in a karaoke bar. I have friends on all kinds of levels. I have friends that are accountants and they make some multi-millions of dollars. I have friends that are opinion leaders. And sometimes I find myself judging myself and comparing myself to those people. Okay. So my level of success or the idea of success that I have for myself, it might be different than others, okay? But Winston Churchill says that success consists of moving from failure to failure without losing enthusiasm. Okay, so think about that. You are successful if you just simply go from failure to failure, which means failure is important too, without losing enthusiasm. Okay, so if you can still have enthusiasm while striving for your dreams, and you can still have enthusiasm while following your plan, you're succeeding. That's success. So maybe you failed at this idea, but like I said earlier, there's all these different paths to being an artist. There's not just one path. You could go do musical theater, you can go do TV, you can go do film, you can record records. There's all these different ways of being successful at being a singer. So you just have to find what works for you. So your first step is sending Stacy Francis a video of you singing, okay? And I want to hear it. I want to hear what your, I want you to write to me and email to me and tell me what your considerations are, what you feel good about in your voice, what you don't feel good about, the doubts you have, the fear you have. I want to hear all of that, and I want us to work together through it. If you have a mother that's saying, you will not be a singer, I want to know about her. I just want to hear what's going on in your universe that's actually stopping you from walking the path of being a singer. And I think because I have had some successes and some wins and had, you know, worked on really big stages and really small stages and musical theater and Broadway and off-Broadway and off-West End and West End, I've done a lot of things. And sometimes, you know, I've had to say, okay, for my own personal integrity, what do I think about me walking down this path? Not what other people think about it, but me. Like, what is this project going to give me? If I go do an off-Broadway show, what am I getting from that? And a lot of times when I've taken an off-Broadway show, if I've taken a show that's £300 a week or $300 a week and it's really not paying me, it's because it's feeding me as an artist. As an artist, I feel fed. I got to act, sing, and dance in this play, or I really believed in it. I wanted to communicate a message. I wanted to inspire people. So I decided that I'm only going to take this little bit of money. Because sometimes it's not just about money. It's what feeds you and how you use any platform to help people, to inspire people, to infuse into society and into a culture that really needs it, some life. Okay, so that's where we're going, all right? That's what this series is going to give you. This is my second video, like I said. I really would love for you to go watch the first one, but stay with me during this journey, because I think, like, us plowing through the barrier of doubt, the barrier of fear, the barrier of the things that stopped you is basically the first thing we need to work on. It's really the first thing we need to work on. I know so many singers that are amazing that they're working full-time as a waitress, or they're working full time for their mom and dad. And that's fine. You can do those things, but you have to implement your art at some point. And the goal is to eventually let that go and work in this art full time. So let's take those steps together. I want to help you. I want to help you confront those fears. I want to help you vocally. At some point, we're going to go over what it takes to sustain your voice, vocal health, vocal ability, all of these things we're going to approach. But unfortunately, the psychology, the emotion is the first thing we have to work through, because the judgment and feeling like, oh, well, you know, that person has $2 million in the bank and they're an accountant, and here I am at this age and I haven't achieved my goals, and to invalidate yourself and continue to compare yourself is not going to work. Okay. We have to stop doing that. So you have to understand that tomorrow, if you say, okay, I decided, Stacy, I'm going to sing. Okay, great. You know what could happen next week with that one decision? You can get a phone call and your whole life can change. I mean, we as artists, we're always waiting for that major thing to happen. But if you don't walk in it, and if you don't decide, hey, this is what I want to do, your major moment might not ever come, because you're over there doing something completely off your purpose line. So I want to help you get on that purpose line. Okay, so the first step last week was to make a decision. And this week, I want you to send me a video. Okay, you're going to send me a video. I'm going to listen to it. We're going to have a little commentary back and forth via email, and I'm going to help you through this process. Okay, so there you go. There's step two. This is video number two. Subscribe, leave a comment, and continue following me because I got some jewels to share with you. Okay, thank you.